G'day there, this is Derek from MovieStudiosN.com. In this video tutorial, I'm just going to answer some questions I get continuously about which screen recording program I use to make my tutorials with. I use My Screen Recorder by DeskShare. That's what it's actually called. So go to their website. Here we go. And there's two versions you can get. You can get My Screen Recorder or My Screen Recorder Pro. The basic version is about $50. The pro version is about $100. Just on buying any software, just remember to do this trick. I always Google the name of the software and add the word coupon, and then you can find websites which will offer you coupons 20 to 30% off the software, which is a pretty good saving. So I just use the basic version, as I said, and it records in Windows Media Video or to AVI Video. The Pro version does a couple extra ones. So I'll get straight into the software because I basically want to just show you the settings that I use. The first thing you're going to have to make sure that you get right is actually in your Windows settings. So go down to the little speaker, right click, go to Recording Devices, and I'm using a Rode Podcaster, which is showing up there. But you've got to be careful, so because if you've got a microphone connected to your computer, your webcam, which also has a microphone, you don't want both of them going at the same time. So you want to make sure that just one's turned on. Double click it, go to levels, and you're also going to make sure that the levels are correct, okay? Sometimes it'll go to zero, and that's why nothing's recording. So remember that you've got to check all that sort of stuff in your Windows controls before you do anything, okay? Okay, right, now into the software. The main settings are all under, well, you can press settings or go to tools, settings. I'll just run through the whole list here and show you what I've done. I leave that unticked. Play video after recording is complete. I don't do that. I always want to do manual control. Display a countdown before recording starts. Yep, I always have that on. Ask for file name. Yep, I've got that selected. You can change the temporary working folder where you want that to be on your computer, or it sets a default value. You can change the color scheme for the software, language, blah, blah, blah. Let's go to recording. I always record in full screen mode, or you can do custom region. Make sure record audio is also ticked. That's very important, otherwise you won't hear anything. And you also then got to select what the recording device is. So I've got my microphone connected. You can also click that, and that'll go to those Windows settings there. You can do it that way to get your levels right. And there's an extra function here. So say if you're doing gameplay video, you can have that ticked. So it records everything that's coming out of the computer as well as what's happening with the microphone. Capture mouse cursor while recording. So you can have that on or off. Capture translucent windows. I never have that selected. I just have that turned off. I've got those there. I always use boost screen recording performance, but you need a really good computer for that to work properly. Let's go to format. Here's where the magic happens. You can do it to AVI or Windows Media Video. I hate AVI because the files are just too friggin' huge. So Windows Media Video works brilliantly with this program. That's why I use this one. So do that. Then video profile. There's tons there. You can choose any of them, but I go straight to custom profile. Then click the custom button. And I use Windows Media Video 9 Advanced Profile. You can set the frame rate to whatever you want. I want really good quality, so I set it to 25 frames per second. But you can set it all the way down to very low if you wish, or right up to 30. I think 25 is pretty cool. I have my bit rate set to maximum, which is 5,000 kilobits per second or 5 megabits per second. Keyframe rate, I set that to 5. Audio compressor, I use Windows Media Audio 9.2. And I record, there's tons of different audio recording settings. Do experiments, I use the highest value there. Click OK. And so then all your stuff will come down there. Display. I disabled that. Some of these things, you can work these out yourself. They're all pretty basic. Disable screensaver, that's obvious. Hide desktop icons while recording. You can have that turned on or off. Auto hide the taskbar. That's just your taskbar in Windows down the bottom. Display settings. This is a fairly important thing. This will all depend on what size and shape your computer monitor is. That's why they've got just about every combination listed in the universe here. What I do is, even though my monitor is 1920x1080, so remember this is for tutorials, not for gameplay, I always record at 1600x900. So that what that effectively does is it blows the screen up so that all the words and text become much bigger, so they're easier for everyone to see. So I do that deliberately. If I recorded at 1920x1080, and then people watch my tutorials on a very, very small laptop, then they're not going to be able to read any of the text at all. So that's why I choose that. But if you were doing like gameplay, then obviously you probably would do 1920x1080. But that's one of those areas where you can do some experiments in. I just leave that as default on that setting there. And keyboard is just telling you your controls. So I press F8 to start recording, and I press F9 when I want to finish recording, and then it automatically saves it. So that's about it. There's heaps of other things. The other stuff is all stuff you can work out yourself. But that's the most important stuff. I hope that helps you out. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening, and I'll catch you next time. Ciao.